Namaskaram and hello everyone. Welcome to Maitri. I hope all of you are healthy and happy. The main purpose of this life is to be very healthy and happy. Since the time we are born till we die, we look forward to do anything to be very healthy and happy. We are all into different professions like doctor, homemakers, business people, teachers and many more. So all the people are aimed in earning money eventually, which will help them to be very healthy and happy. So that is the main purpose of livelihood, which actually everybody does. So throughout this period, if we have any health issues, we go to a person whom we think will guide us and makes us sail through the difficult times of ill health. So that person is a doctor. Doctor or a physician. In ancient India, he was also called as Vaidya. Basically, Vaidya in ancient India means the one with profound knowledge of the scriptures, of the constitution of a person also. This doctor or a physician or Vaidya supposed to have a thorough knowledge about the constitution of the patient. According to Ayurveda, he should have thorough knowledge about Tridoshas and Saptadhatus, based on which he will diagnose the person and then he will start his treatment. It was also said by the great Sushruta and Charaka, the qualities of a doctor or a good doctor, ideal doctor should be, like he should be very patient, he should have good memory, he should have good speaking skills, communication skills, he should be very friendly, he should have compassion. At the same time, he should be able to hold any conclusion or diagnosis to himself sometimes, just in case if it is going to harm or if it is going to cause any potential harm to the patient. He should not be money-minded. His whole and soul aim and goal should be to see the patient very healthy and happy. So the same thing is followed by all the doctors, starting with Ayurveda, naturopathy, homeopathy, Siddha, Yunani, and of course modern medicine too. Our scriptures also say that doctors should be very healthy and he should be modest, he should be truthful, and he should be very clean and tidy. This is in order to avoid infection to his patient. And in olden days, the doctors actually never had the clinics. They used to go to their home and treat the patients and come back. So they were actually considered as a family doctor who used to be like a family member, who used to keep all their secrets to himself and who used to guide them very nicely in any kind of health related issue. So that may be very small or a big. And in ancient India, kings were having separate doctors. So they were called Rajavaidyas. Even now, in very few places, very few doctors are there, these family doctors who are really wonderful and guide the people very nicely in a right way, which kind of treatments should be followed and what kind of treatment should be followed at what time. Wonderful doctors are there. But majority of the doctors are too busy these days to maintain such kind of healthy relationship with the patients. They are seeing at least, more than 200 patients or sometimes 400 patients per day in their clinics who are very busy. They are majorly looking after either their own clinics or working in the corporate hospitals. But always remember that we have a wonderful doctor in our home only. So you might wonder who, because every house doesn't have a doctor. Since time immemorial, people in India have been following only the household remedies to be very healthy and happy. So if you go to the history and see, not only in India, in many countries all over the world have used only their household remedies to stay very healthy and happy, unless there occurs any medical emergency. So always remember, your house is a hospital, your kitchen is a pharmacy, and your mother is a doctor. As I just mentioned, that the doctor should be knowing the patient's constitution very well in order to diagnose properly and treat the patient properly. And same way, and in fact more than the doctor, mother knows the child's constitution very well and she gives a guidance and she treats the child in a very proper way in every season and every day with just her kitchen herbs. Not only the child, but she looks after all the people in the house. She knows When are they sick? When are they healthy? When are they hungry? When are they not hungry? How is their constitution? She knows very well. And she either cooks accordingly or she gives some kind of remedial herbs from her kitchen. So consider your kitchen as a pharmacy and your mother as a doctor. And only if it is not manageable with her and with the herbs which are present in your home, and then think of going to a doctor. I wish all of you to find the best and the wonderful doctor, especially who can guide you in your illness, who can just make you sail through that pain easily, more than a doctor who is just a better guide and a friend to you. And just to remind all of you that July 1st is National Doctors' Day. So wish you all a very happy Doctors' Day. Thank you very much. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell icon. Thank you and see you in the next video.